Kurunji Senior Secondary School CBSE Namakkal.
Successful result producing school in state every year.
Administered by the board of directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hi students, so in this video we are going to discuss regarding subaerial stem modifications. So subaerial stem modifications, so there are four different types are there. So what are those? Runners, stolons, suckers, offsets. So there in previous video, runners information as well as stolons information I have given. So examples also I have mentioned here, once you concentrate on those. And one more, today we are going to discuss elaborate information on remaining two, that is suckers, and one more is offsets along with that particular information. So here the four diagrams of subaerial stem modifications, and after completion of subaerial stem modifications, so we will concentrate on the aerial stem modifications. So aerial stem modifications information again half only I have given, remaining of definitely I will cover in next video. So come, let us have a look on the subaerial stem modifications. Okay man, now subaerial stem modifications, so how many types are there? Four types. Subaerial stem modifications, four types are there. So what are those? Runners, stolons, suckers, offsets. So try to by heart this order: runners, stolons, suckers, offsets. Now runners information everything we have learned in yesterday's class itself. So that's why one more time I would like to explain the which one examples only. So runners, cynodon, dubgrass, fragaria, scientific name of strawberry. Next one, oxalis, and one more is hydrocotyle vulgaris. Runners examples: cynodon, dubgrass, fragaria, strawberry, oxalis, hydrocotyle vulgaris. So these examples which are comes under or which will come under runners. Next one, stolons concerned: nerium, jasminum, rosa, or means rosama, rosa, and one more is mentha, mint plant. One more time: stolons, nerium, jasminum, rosa, and one more is mentha, mentha, mint plant. Okay, so these are four examples we can be taken under stolons. So here in stolons, now these stolons grow somehow positively, or that grows downwards towards the soil. So when that particular branches or lower branches of the stem touches to the or comes to the contact with the soil, at the time now definitely, so with turn roots of formation takes place. So after formation of roots, so definitely, so that particular plant, suppose if you separate that particular branch, if you separate from the parental plant, no, definitely that particular daughter plant can live independently. So that point we have seen in stolons. Now suckers information concern. So suckers information, what are the main important points to be covered means? So these suckers are partially underground. Okay, partially or partly underground, and partly aerial. So that's why here we have written as subaerial. Okay, partly underground and partly aerial, or partially also we can write partially underground and partially aerial. Okay, so obliquely growing axillary branches. So these are all obliquely growing. So how they will grow? Obliquely upward. So here diagrams also definitely I'll explain one by one. So first of all, information, let us have a look on this. So partly underground stem modifications, so partly aerial stem modifications. So these kind of suckers grows obliquely growing axillary branches known as suckers. So there, this is a subaerial branch arising from the basal underground portion of the main stem. So here branches development will be there. Those branches developing from the basal underground stem portion of the main stem. Okay, so from the basal main axis of the stem will be there, main axis. So from that main axis, no, basal underground portion. So from the basal underground portion, so which one formation takes place? Branches formation takes place. So now these branches initially grows horizontally below the surface and but soon grows obliquely upwards. Once you see there, obliquely downwards. So here obliquely downwards, forming a leaf, obliquely downwards. So definitely this grows so obliquely upward. Okay, one more time, you see there, initially it grows horizontally below the surface, but soon grows obliquely upward. Okay, so means in this particular case, so once you come on to the diagram, so here this is a sucker information. So here initially this particular branch growing parallelly, so within the surface. So later that grows obliquely upward. But here in case of the stolons, you see there, stolons. So here the lower branches are rising, growing aerially, and these branches now again grows towards the soil. Means grows obliquely downwards. We see now in stolons, obliquely downwards and touches to the ground. So where it touches the ground, you know, or the soil, no, definitely roots of formation takes place. So later, so we can be seeing the development of plants. So here, after a few days, means once the root formation completed, suppose if you cut the plant, so here if you cut the plant like this, exactly like that, if you cut the plant, no, definitely this particular plant, it can act as individual one or independent one. So okay, that one is in case of stolons under this diagram. So suckers, so here in stolons, what is the point? So lower branches grows upward or obliquely upwards, initially obliquely upwards, but grows downwards towards the soil. Okay, and this one grows parallelly and later grows obliquely upward. So thereby, what is the conclusion point now under stolons and suckers? I am going to give you is stolons grows obliquely downwards. Stolons grows obliquely downwards and suckers grows obliquely upward. So here in stolons, in yesterday's explanation or a previous video explanation, so I have given stolons definitely grows obliquely downwards. Okay, next one, suckers grows so obliquely upwards. So these two points are definitely you have to save in your mind. So other than the data, so are these two points only main important when compared to the remaining points. Okay, so suckers point of view, so what are the examples we can be seen? Okay, so first of all, adventitious roots develops from the underground nodes and leaves from the aerial nodes. So this point we now need to discuss. So definitely adventitious roots development takes place at nodes only, at nodal regions, and leaves from the aerial nodes. So here at aerial nodes, you know, leaves formation, and here, so where the plant body touches to the ground, so from there, suppose if you find nodes, you know, in that particular nodes onwards, we can see the formation of adventitious roots. Emma, so means up to here, what is information we learn? Runners we learn, and stolons we learn. Next one, suckers we learn. Runners point of view, runners diagram also once I'll explain, once you see the diagram. So runners, so this is the structure of runners. So likewise grass, did you see creepers, creeping grass? So there exactly at a nodal regions, you know, we can find out group of roots, adventitious roots we can find out, and exactly at aerial part, you know, we can be seen shoot system. So means here also these runners also, suppose here exactly at spotlight, suppose if the main plant body is detached, means separated, means so this individual one can act as that particular plant can act or that can survive as independently or independent plant. So likewise, so these runners, stolons, suckers, offsets, there are different types of subaerial stem modifications are there, all are involved in vegetative propagation. Okay, now examples concerned, examples of suckers. So what are the examples are there? Chrysanthemum, Musa, Chrysanthemum, you know very well, and Musa. So I have given already banana, and the next one ananas. Ananas is a pineapple. So likewise, there are different types of examples we can be seen in suckers. Next one, offsets concern. So offsets are main important points. What are the main important points? No, a weak horizontal branch of one internodal. Or what internode region? So a weak horizontal branch of one internode. Okay, suppose a horizontal branch will be there, seems to be very weak at one or with one internode. So if it is there, you know, so such kind of structure we can be taken as offsets. It is similar to the runner. So once you see there, runner's structure as well as offset's structure is the same only, seems to be like or similar to the runner and originated from the axil of leaf but has only one internode. So here these offsets are develops only where in axillary leaf, okay, originates from the axil of leaf but has only one internode. Okay, so this point also try to save in your mind. Next one, it runs horizontal to the surface producing tuft of leaves. Tuft means group or bunch. So here when this particular offset growing parallel, you know, the tuft of leaves or the group of or the bunch of leaves arranged like this. Why? Because so here one important point here we can be taken, condensed stem we can be taken. So condensed stem when or reduced stem also. So when condensed or reduced stem is present, so here the leaf like structures are arranged in rosette manner. The leaf like structures are arranged in rosette manner. Okay, so suppose when you observe that rose flower, no, there how we will observe the color arrangement of color petals, no? So likewise here also tuft of leaves, the tuft of leaves arrangement will be there like rosette manner. That's why such kind of arrangement we will be taking as offsets. So next one, adventitious roots also, tuft of adventitious roots or the group of adventitious roots are present, and when these offsets are separated or the detached from the main plant body, so they can live as independent one. So that information only, when they separated from the parent plant, offsets grow into an independent plant. So what are the examples? So generally we can be seen under this one means Pistia, water cabbage. Pistia also known as water cabbage. Next one, Icornia, also called as water hyacinth. Don't forget, Pistia also known as water cabbage. Icornia also known as water hyacinth. Next one, Agave Americana or Agave also known as century plant. Okay, Agave also known as century plant. Icornia also known as water hyacinth. Next one, Pistia also known as water cabbage. So likewise, there are different types of examples we can be seen in offsets. So here one important point I would like to highlight. So that is if you see the structures in offsets, no, I have drawn one some kind of a pocket like structures, no. So thereby here what is the point we have to remember, no, in offsets means offsets definitely. So here we can be seen in hydrophytes, these Pistia, Icornia or hydrophytes. So in a while explanation of root information, so I gave one important point, that is in hydrophytes root pockets are present. So in hydrophytes root pockets are present. Root pockets definitely helps in buoyancy of that particular plant, whereas in a terrestrial plant, no, definitely root caps are present. So that point we have seen now. Offsets examples, one is Pistia and one more is Icornia. Icornia, do you know why? Icornia is also known as water hyacinth. So the definitely we can be seen very greenery structures or very green color plants in stagnant water bodies. So that one only. So is Icornia. This particular Icornia we are calling by one more name. What is that one more name? No, Terror of Bengal. So here, Terror of Bengal, this information in second year explanation. So you will learn. Okay. So now here, runners, stolons, suckers, offsets. So these are four diagrams. What are those? runners, stolons, suckers, offsets. So these are four side headings which are belongs to the subaerial stem modifications. Now aerial stem modifications. So aerial stem modifications concerned, what are the main important points to be discussed means. So under aerial stem modifications, in some plants, aerial stem buds undergo modifications to perform functions such as climbing, protection, synthesis of food, and one more is vegetative propagation. So there are different types of modifications are there. So what are those? Definitely all these kind of modifications performs different types of functions. So what are the functions generally they performs means helps in climbing and definitely helps in protection and synthesis of food. Next one is vegetative propagation. Likewise, there are different types of modifications we can be seen in aerial stem modifications. So now let us have a look on one by one. So first of all, let us concentrate on the stem tendrils, or simply you can write it as tendrils. Okay, so these tendrils, thin wiry sensitive structure, so sensitive also I have written. Once you see the thin wiry leafless spirally coiled sensitive climbing organs known as tendrils. So tendrils for everyone, each and everyone knew very very well about it. So wiry structures and spirally coiled structures and sensitive and climbing organs. So here climbing organs definitely helps to the climbing, the word itself giving. So the organs which are helps or which helps in climbing. Okay, ma. So here the movement of these or the transfer movement of these tendrils only. So thigmotropic we will call. So thigmotropism. So phenomenon is thigmotropism. Suppose here the tendrils are not having eyes and all to see and to get support with the substratum. So in this particular case, no. So here the movement of the tendrils or the phenomenon of this tendril we can be taken as thigmotropic or thigmotropism. Thigmotropic, thigmotropic or thigmotropism is phenomena. So next one, these are found in plants with weak aerial stems. So suppose where we can see, sir, these kind of tendrils, sir, means definitely that particular plant must be aerial and that particular stem definitely must be weak in condition. So one more time you see there, these are all found in plants with weak aerial stems. So where we are finding with weak aerial stem, no, in that particular case definitely for a climbing concern or the climbing purpose point of view, these tendrils helps. So for example, sir, either one particular example, sir, try to give, sir, means. So here once you see that in white is vinifera. White is genus only I have written. Genus is enough to identify the plant. So white is vinifera grapes, or simply grape wine also you can remember, or simply you can try to remember as grape only. Grapes plant scientific name is white is vinifera. So in white is vinifera terminal bud. So means here if you take buds, no, here suppose here what is information, there are on stem, no, there are two different types of buds are present. One is terminal and one more is axillary buds, no. So terminal bud only we are calling by apical bud. So likewise, so now here this terminal bud is modified into tendrils. Suppose if the terminal bud means in case of white is vinifera, terminal bud modified into tendrils. Next one, gods like. So here gods like, what are the gods we can be seen? So cucumber, pumpkin, watermelon. So some kind of gods, no. So their axillary bud modified into tendrils. So here whether that particular bud or that particular bud may be axillary or terminal, so based on that also, so sometimes a chance is there to ask, means here these are tendrils of examples concerned. So terminal bud or apical bud we are observing in white is vinifera, means grapes. Next one, axillary bud develops into tendrils in case of cucumber, pumpkin, watermelon. So examples need examination point of view important, try to concentrate. Next one, thorns concern. So here these thorns are hard, thorns are there. So what are these thorns, what is the importance of these thorns, no? A hard pointed woody straight structures. Emma, one more time, hard pointed woody straight structures which are modified part of axillary bud or terminal bud. MSO means so pointed hard structures or pointed structures, woody straight structures. Okay, means pointed structures you have seen. So thorns are definitely before. Okay, we have experienced with the effect of thorns. So there. So suppose for example rose flower. So when you have observed the rose flower now just on the peduncle, so definitely you can see the presence of thorns. Okay, so that's why I said we have experienced with the thorns of rose. Okay, so there. Now what is information I am going to give you is hard, pointed, woody straight structures which are modified the part of axillary buds or terminal buds. Now these thorns definitely helps in, so definitely these thorns helps in protection. So these thorns helps in protection, and definitely these thorns consist of vascular bundles. So this point mainly I would like to highlight in this particular video. So in comparison of all important points, no, so this point I would like to highlight. Why? Because NEET examination point of view, whether they will give or not, that you keep it beside. But so what is the main important difference of thorns and spines means? So in thorns definitely we can be seen the presence of vascular bundles. So in thorns, why? Because these thorns are modifications of stem. So these thorns are modifications of stem, that's why. So definitely we are observing the presence of vascular bundles in a thorns. Okay, next one, examples concerned. So sir, what are the examples? What are the examples we can be taken under? Under thorns means bougainvillea. So bougainvillea, paper flowers, do you know? So paper flowers, scientific name only, bougainvillea. There axillary bud is modified into thorn. So means in a paper flowers plant, no, definitely you have seen or you have experienced with the presence of thorns there. That particular thorn, from where it has been developed, it has been or it is developed from the axillary bud. So in bougainvillea means paper flowers, there axillary bud modified into thorn. Okay, now here these thorns also present in a few species of citrus. So definitely, so lemon, I think so, in a lemon plant also, so we have seen the presence of thorns. So these thorns also present in a few species of citrus. Citrus species also we can be seen or we have seen the presence of thorns. Next one, these thorns protects the plants from the browsing animals. So that's one. Everyone knew very well about it. Means definitely these thorns helps in protection. So already before this point only I have mentioned. So means because of the pointed structure or because of the woody nature or hard structures, no, definitely these thorns protects the plant from the browsing animals or herbaceous animals. Okay, and these thorns somewhat reduces the rate of transpiration also. Okay, so definitely that point also we can consider. But most important point, so definitely these thorns protects the main plant or the plant body from the herbaceous or browsing animals. So that point I try to save in your mind. Next one, so what are the best examples we can be taken under thorns means? So these points by searching in internet, so again by referring of old books I am giving you, so try to save these examples in your mind. So first of all, under thorns, what are the examples I have given? Bougainvillea, now I have given. Citrus I have given. Now, Punica granatum. Punica granatum is a scientific name of pomegranate. Try to buy hot this one. Punica granatum, scientific name of pomegranate. Next one, Durantha. Another name I referred, but I didn't get this one. So next one. So now here totally bougainvillea, citrus, pomegranate, Durantha, and okay, so that's enough. So here I think so one more also is there, Carissa carandus. So here the Carissa, so means totally over 5 or 6 examples, bougainvillea, citrus, pomegranate, Durantha, and Carissa, 5 examples now I am giving you under tons. Okay, ma. So nowadays the importance of all these things. Now let us see. Punica granatum, pomegranate. So in punica granatum, axillary bud only develops into thorns. So this particular thorns means in punica granatum, no. So we are observing the thorns. These thorns consist of leaves as well as branches. So don't forget this point. Important means on the punica granatum. Thorns. So what is the things we can be seen? Leaves as well as branches we can be seen. Next one in a Duranta. So in case of Duranta, again axillary bud helps in the development of thorns. Now these thorns consist of leaves as well as flowers. Okay, leaves and branches present in thorns of pomegranate, and leaves as well as flowers are present in thorns of Duranta. So these two points try to save in your mind, very very important. One more time, leaves and flowers are present in the thorns of Duranta. Next one, leaves and branches are present in the thorns of pomegranate. Okay ma. And interesting thing is punica granatum as well as Duranta also both are developed from the axillary buds. So means in punica granatum thorns as well as in Duranta also thorns are definitely developed from the axillary bud. So now axillary, sir, here all are axillary buds only are there. So try to give an example for apical bud, sir, means apical bud example. So means here the apical bud definitely involves in the formation of thorns. Means here the thorns, so in carries a carandus, so thorns are developed from the apical bud. So that information I can give you. So next side heading, phylloclade. So in phylloclade, so actually to write the down I don't have place, that's why so last point here I have written. So what is the point I would like to highlight means, so in phylloclade leaves are modified into spines. So these spines are not consisting of vascular bundles. Okay, one more time. So here the phylloclade. So best example of a phylloclade, open shema. So best example, once I have drawn here one diagram. Now you have seen which one the structure of open shema. No? So there. So phylloclade. In phylloclade, leaf-like structures. Means leaves are modified into spines without vascular bundles. So means thereby, what is the point? If you see the structure of thorns there. So thorn is stem modifications, no? Stem modification, no? That's why we have seen the presence of vascular bundle. But here leaves are modified into spines. Means now the spines are modifications of leaf, no? So that's why here we could not see the presence of vascular bundle. So means in thorns we can see the presence of vascular bundles, whereas in spines no, so vascular bundles are absent. Okay, so that point I would like to highlight first. Next one, so this phylloclade means what is information? No, green modified stem, so that performs the process of photosynthesis. Sir, here why, sir, this particular stem only performing the process of photosynthesis means, so before this point, once you see their leaves are modified into spines. Now leaves only modified into spines means then nothing is there to perform the process of photosynthesis, but that particular plant must survive. No, how it will survive means, so in that kind of a plants, no, stem only performs the process of photosynthesis. Don't forget important point. Next one, in this phyllod, this is a modified stem found in xerophytic plants. Sir, this kind of photosynthetic plant where we can be seen, sir, means, so definitely this kind of modified stem we can be seen in xerophytic plants. In xerophytic plants means the plants which are present in desert areas. So such kind of plants we will be taking as xerophytic plants to reduce the water loss. So here, to reduce the water loss, once you see there, so now only I said xerophytic plants means the plants which are growing in desert areas. I said no. So in this particular case, no, what are the plants growing in a desert areas? Definitely they are suffer from the lack of water or the scarcity of water. In that particular case, no, suppose once you see there xerophytic plants, to reduce the water loss as the leaves are modified into spines. So that's why in xerophytic plants, what is the point now I am going to highlight? So in xerophytic plants, definitely leaves are modified into spines. So why? Because So suppose if the leaves are there, means within the leaves structures, no, we can see the presence of stomata. Because of the presence of stomata, water loss process takes place. So definitely water loss by the process of transpiration. That's why now if the leaf is modified into spines, means definitely that particular water loss we can reduce. A point you understood or not? That's why here, so in xerophytic plants, the leaves are modified into spines to reduce the rate of transpiration. Emma, so this point is important. Next one, phylloclade of Wappensia belongs to the, or this particular Wappensia belongs to the Cactaceae family. So you have seen this cactus or cactus plants. So plant storages will be there, no, or in gardens or in botanical gardens or some kind of places. So definitely we can be seen the cactus family members. So represented by many flattened fleshy internodes and leaves at nodal positions or modified into spines or barbs. Means see here, what is the point? So the phylloclade of Wappensia Cactaceae family members represented by many flattened fleshy internodes. So here in Wappensia, so flattened structure, the flattened internodes, nodes and internodes are present in stem only, no. So they are flattened fleshy internodes and leaves at nodal positions. Okay, leaves at a nodal positions. So definitely are modified into spines or barbs. Barbs are nothing but small pinous leaves. Spinous means very pointed structures we can be seen. So small pointed structures only we will be calling as a barb. Okay, so means in Wappensia, what is the point I would like to highlight mainly? Means here, flattened stem which performs the process of photosynthesis. Now under phylloclade, two examples are, these two are textbook points important for NEET examinations. In Euphorbia, cylindrical stem performs the process of photosynthesis. Don't forget, in Euphorbia, cylindrical flesh stem performs the process of photosynthesis, whereas in Wappensia, flattened flesh stem performs the process of photosynthesis. One more time, once you see there, Euphorbia, cylindrical flesh stem performs the process of photosynthesis. And one more, Wappensia, flattened flesh stem performs the process of photosynthesis. Now, once you see the diagram of this one, so this is the structure of a phylloclade. Under, I have written, so to avoid the confusion, so phylloclade, which is coming under aerial stem, best example of this diagram is comes under Wappensia. So this is a diagram belongs to Wappensia. So flattened stem performs the process of photosynthesis. On this stem, we are observing pointed structures. These structures only we will be calling as spines modified from the leaves. So likewise, somewhat information I have given under phylloclade. So there in this particular video, where I have concentrated on subaerial stem modifications, so four types, and in aerial stem modifications I have focused mainly on tendrils, thorns and phylloclade. Still a few more kind of modifications are there to be discussed. Thank you, ma. But you try to see this video very clearly. So suppose if you are not able to understand all these examples or not able to remember these kind of information, so try to watch this video two or three times. So then only you can remember this entire information without any confusions. So definitely don't forget one point. You are preparing for NEET examinations means. So apart from the textbook only, we will give more information. Okay. Along by covering of textbook information, definitely we will give more information. Okay, so that's why try to revise these videos and try to learn the more concept and be a good student. Thank you, ma'am.